Danny Cormier has one son, Travis. He's 24 years old now, and he's been dabbling in dairy for half his lifetime. He started helping out when he was 12. Cows are second nature to Travis now. Cleaning barns, moving cattle, artificially inseminating, he's almost as good as his dad. But will he follow in his dad's footsteps? It's the $64 million question these days. Will there be another generation of Cormiers farming in the valley?
There's not a lot of young people around in the Cadre Valley now, so I mean, coming back here now is, there's not a big social life here in the winter months, but I mean, it's a great opportunity. Everybody's always asking me, are you gonna come home and work on the farm? I worked here last summer. I came back from Alberta, worked here. Seems like I'm always getting drawn back here some way or another, so. I enjoy the work too, especially working with family. It's a rare, good opportunity.
If Travis one day decided for certain that he wanted to come home and follow in your footsteps,
yeah,
how would you feel about that?
Oh, I'd love it. Because right now, I mean, there's no succession at all right across the country. And to be lucky enough to have a son right now come and take over, you know, I'd love it.
A certain grandfather would love it too. A grandfather who only ever wanted a life for his family in the valley.
I was determined to build up something for the family to work, keep them around. And it worked.
Not all nine Cormier children stayed on the farm, but those who didn't have still done well in life. Perhaps because they had that foundation to stand on, the foundation they helped their parents build way back in the 60s in this Valley of the Winds. Next on Land and Sea, we begin our spring and summer repeats on the north coast of Labrador. We follow three Makovic hunters in their search for spring seals all the way to the edge of the ice. That story next week on Land and Sea.